Hello, welcome everybody. This is Dr. Bolad, board certified physician in cardiology, interventional cardiology, and internal medicine. I am here to help you with all the information you need for your heart health and informing you about the latest developments and information and treatments in cardiology. If you are new to this channel, then definitely consider hitting the subscribe button below and switch on the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos that I post. Today, I will talk to you about the arteries of the heart, medically known as the coronary arteries. These arteries deliver oxygenated blood to the muscle of the heart, which is vital in keeping the heart alive and beating regularly. The ostia of the coronary arteries originate from the sinuses of Valsalva at the root of the aorta, as shown in this diagram. There are variations that occur in a very small percentage of patients, and I will not dwell on these variations. The left main coronary artery originates from the left sinus of Valsalva and divides into two main branches, the left anterior descending and the circumflex coronary arteries, supplying most of the left ventricular myocardium. The left anterior descending artery, after its origin, courses across the front of the heart in the anterior interventricular groove to the apex of the heart, as shown here on the right side of the screen in this heart during autopsy. During its course, it supplies branches to the left ventricle, the main pumping chamber of the heart. The branches include the septal arteries, supplying the interventricular septum, separating the right from the left ventricle, and the diagonal branches supplying the left lateral part of the heart. During its course, like all arteries, the left anterior descending artery becomes smaller in size as it courses from the origin from the left main stem to the apex of the heart, as it supplies less myocardium. You can imagine the coronary arteries like this tree. The origin is the left main coronary artery, is the trunk of this tree. The trunk then divides into large branches. In the left main coronary analogy, the left anterior descending artery and the circumflex artery. The two arteries give smaller and smaller branches as they course, just like this tree, and eventually lots of leaves, which is analogous to the arterioles that feed the muscle of the heart. The circumflex coronary is the other large branch of the left main coronary artery. It courses to the left in the left atrioventricular groove. The distribution is quite variable. It provides branches to the lateral part of the left ventricle. These branches are called the obtuse margin branches. In 10% of patients, the circumflex artery is a large artery, and in addition to supplying the lateral wall of the left ventricle, it continues and also supplies the inferior wall of the left ventricle. In this instance, we label the coronary circulation as left dominant circulation. The right coronary artery originates from the right sinus of Valsalva. After its origin, it courses to the right in the atrioventricular groove, as shown here in the left side of the screen. It branches as it courses to supply the right atrium and ventricle. These branches are the conus and sinoatrial branches, the right ventricular branch, the acute marginal branch, the posterior descending artery, and the posterior lateral artery branch. This is the anatomy in 90% of cases, and in this situation, the circulation is labeled as right dominant. In 10% of patients, the right coronary artery is a small artery, and the circumflex artery is a large artery, and the circulation is labeled as left dominant, as stated earlier. This diagram shows the three main arteries of the heart and their branches. From the left sinus of Valsalva, from the aorta, originates the left main artery, labeled here as LCA, which stands for left common coronary artery, as shown on the left side of the diagram. From the left main originates the left anterior descending artery and gives rise to diagonal branches and septal branches, supplying the interventricular septum and the majority of the front wall of the left ventricle. The circumflex artery also originates from the left main artery and gives rise to marginal branches, which supplies the lateral part of the left ventricle. The right coronary artery originates from the right sinus of Valsalva, from the aorta. It gives rise to multiple branches, supplying the right ventricle. Depending on the origin of the posterior descending artery, which supplies the lower part of the heart, the coronary circulation is either labeled right dominant or left dominant. If the posterior descending artery originates from the right coronary artery, which it does in 90% of cases, the circulation is labeled as right dominant. If the posterior descending artery originates from the circumflex artery, which it does in 10% of people, the coronary circulation is labeled as left dominant. If you have any question about what I presented to you today, or any cardiology question in general, then subscribe to this channel and share your question in the comment section below, and I will reply to you. If you have a question that you would not like to share in public, then subscribe to this channel, follow me in Twitter at Dr. Bolad, and then send me a private Twitter direct message and I will reply to you. Please like and share this video with family and friends. This is Dr. Bolad, helping you with your heart health. Thanks for watching, and talk to you soon.